Morning students, as we have discussed in last class about the matter, its example and its various properties, today I am going to start with the topic states of matter. What do you mean by term state? The state means the matter is found in which form? Means matter can be found in three forms. Example is ice. Ice is a matter. Now the question here is, how can you say that ice is a matter? Because ice has some mass and it occupies space. Like if you put the ice cube into a glass of water, then the space occupied by the ice cube into the glass that and having some weight with the glass, that's why it is known as matter. As there are three states of matter, one is solid, second is liquid, third is gas. Very easy example in which we can say this matter has three states. Ice is solid, having some definite shape. And second is liquid. Water in the form of what? When we melt the ice, then we get the water. Water is the liquid. So liquid is also the second state of matter. Third one is the gas. When we boil the liquid, it converts into the vapors and this is known as the gaseous state of water or matter. So we conclude with there are three states of matter: solid, liquid and gas. Now we discuss all these three states in description one by one. Number one is solid. Solid means anything that is solid. Means we can say that this person is very very solid. Like bodybuilder has a very solid body. Okay. Now come to the matter topic. Having solid state means the football you are using, bike you are using, the home in which we are living, the pen, paper, pencil, book, chair. These are the example of solid. Now what are the properties of solid? Means what are the properties of matter that you can say that it is the solid state of matter? Means solid have very very tight particles, or in the solid particles are tightly packed. You can take a bucket and put some balloons into that, then you can say that these balloons are tightly packed. Now there is no space left in that. This is known as the solid state. Other example is you have the almira in your home. Your mother says, "Put the clothes into the almira." But you are saying that there, Mama, there is no space to put the clothes into the almira. How can you say that there is no space to put the clothes? Because the clothes that you have put, that fill the almira fully. Means these clothes are placed one above the other. Now there is no space. Same, I am giving you one more example. As you are sitting on a bench in the classroom, this bench is having three seats, or it's a three-seater bench. The teacher allow the other two students to sit with you, then you can sit by congestion, or you congestly seated. Now teacher says ki sit more, teacher says ki come more, means four students come here and sit or adjust with these five students that are already seated on bench. Then you said, means you all five students that are seated on the bench, you said to the teacher that, ma'am, there is no space, we are already congested, we are seated by as putting fevicol between them. Okay, so means your particles are very closely packed. As your particles are very closely packed, so your movement is very, very slow. If the particles are very, very close, there is no space to move from one place to other. So the movement is very, very slow. We can take very easy other example, your geometry box. Your geometry box has pen, pencil, eraser, sharpener. Suppose your geometry box has the capacity of the 10 pens and one sharpener, one eraser, but I am giving you two more sharpeners, one eraser and five more pencil, and told you to keep these material that I have gave you to put into your geometry box. Then you said that, ma'am, there is no space of even movement. Then you say that particles are very, very closely packed, means we take one pencil as one particle, other pencil as other particle. So mean these particles are very, very close to each other. There is no space for movement. Okay, so this is the example of solid. What are the other properties of solid? Means how can you say that it is solid? Solid has a definite shape. Definite shape means having the shape of rectangle, circle, or square, cube shape, triangle shape. Means we can't say it is having like the amoeba having not the definite shape, like the jelly the students used for their playing purpose do not have the definite shape, but the solid is having a definite shape. Solid having the second property, that is the mass, means having some weight. Solid having some weight means if you put the book into your hand and if the weight of book is very heavy, you can say that, ma'am, it's very, very heavy. Or sometime, suppose you are going for vacation with your parents, your mama said ki keep the luggage on your shoulders. You said, mama, the bag is very, very heavy, means it is having some weight. Okay, so the solid is having some definite shape, definite mass, definite volume. Okay, example is ice, snow, snooker that you are using, helmet. These are the examples of solid. Solids cannot be easily compressible because means we can not press the solid very easily. You cannot press your bicycle or you cannot press your book into your hand, but you can press a empty polythene into your hand because solids are not easily compressible because there is very small space between their particles. Other property of solid is solids cannot flow easily because particles cannot move from one side to other. Can you see that in your home chair is moving on self from one place to other? You can see your bag, school bag is moving from your home to the school? No, because solid particles have very small particle that cannot move easily. Okay, suppose I am giving you three things. You have to recognize them, which one is the solid, which one is liquid and which one is the gas. So example, tree is example of solid because it is having definite mass, definite shape, definite volume. And water is example of liquid. The gas that we are inhaling today, that we need in the corona pandemic time, that is oxygen, that is the gas. Okay, so what we have discussed about today, states of matter. There are three states of matter. And first of all, you should know the meaning of the term state of matter. Name the three states of matter. Give the examples of each state. Describe the solid state. How can you say that it is a solid state? And give other examples that related to the solid state. Now the here one question is, the pizza that we like very very much is solid, liquid or gas? If it is a solid, then you have to give the answer. If pizza is liquid, why it is liquid? If pizza is gas, then you have to tell it is gas. Okay, thank you students. Kindly read the book on daily basis for your better concepts. Okay.